Folks, how many of you are members of this club, Democracy Matters? All right, almost all of you. Okay. I think that's a really cool name for a club, Democracy Matters. And we're going to talk about that, right? We're going to talk about whether democracy really does matter. Now, who agrees with me that the voter turnout in the United States is very bad? Okay. So apparently a lot of people don't think democracy really does matter, right? Okay. And who would agree with me that voter turnout among folks in your age group is really bad, right? So, and I'm not pointing the finger at you folks, because the mere fact that you're here tells me you care. But would you agree with me that generally folks in your age category who have the right to vote by law really don't care? Right? How are we going to change that? How are we going to change that? And do we need to change that? Now, how in this country do we communicate an idea to others? How do we do that? Anybody? You want to communicate a political idea to others, to as many people as you can. How are you going to do it?
Journalism, media, so broadcast, newspapers, social media.
Absolutely. All those things. And those things cost money. Now, would you agree with me that the more money you have, the more you can communicate your message, right? And the more you can persuade the electorate. We agree on that? Money talks, right? We've all heard that. Money talks. Now, some people would argue that in the United States right now, there's a very small group of people that control the electorate and how the electorate thinks. Let's assume for a minute, just for fun, that that's true. Okay? And let's assume that that small group of people are very, very rich, very powerful people. Some would argue that the reason they're rich is because they're smarter than the rest of us. And if you accept that, then perhaps you accept the idea that that small group of people should be able to tell the rest of us what we should do and how this government shall be. Does anybody agree with that idea? That the country should be controlled by a few people who are generally better than the rest of us? Does anybody agree with that? Does anybody disagree with that? Okay. Well, what we're seeing in the United States today is exactly what I'm talking about. We are more and more every day becoming a country that is controlled politically by a very small group of people. They have the money, and they have the resources, and they have the law on their side to control what we think. That's an oligarchy, a government controlled by the few. When I was a kid in third grade, I was taught we're a democracy, that we're not an oligarchy, right? Were you taught we're a democracy? Right? I mean, democracy matters, right? You all agree with that? Democracy matters? Okay. So, if we're going to make democracy really matter, wouldn't it stand to reason that we need to control how much influence really, really rich, powerful people have over campaigns? Wouldn't that stand to reason? Right? Because if you've got 10 bucks in the bank account, and Mr. Koch over here, Koch, K-O-C-H, I don't know if you know the name, has billions, can you compete with him? No, you can't, right? So his vote counts way more than yours. Do we want that? Does anybody want that? No? What's that? Well, of course they do. Of course they want to control what happens. Let me ask. know this is a bipartisan group, and I don't want to have a debate. I just want to have an open discussion. First of all, is everybody here registered to vote? Is anybody registered as a Republican? No Republican. Can't have any fun, man. We need some Republicans in the room. But that's okay. Because I think even young Republicans don't like the idea of our government being controlled and monopolized by a very select, small group of people. Okay. Now, this idea of a small group of people dictating what happens in this country is something that is happening, and it's happening more and more every day. The world that you're entering, the political world that you're entering, is vastly different than the world Dave and I entered when we graduated from SUNY Cortland back in the Stone Age. Okay? Vastly different. And I'll tell you why. Because the rules have changed to benefit the rich and the powerful. We all agree, we've already discussed it, that the way to control the electorate is with money. If we want to have a true democracy, we need to control how much money can be pumped into a campaign by an individual. Okay. Well, in the 1970s, there was a case that said, or stood for the idea, that money is speech. That sounded kind of innocent on its face, right? And it's pretty much accurate. Well, that led to a problem, and that problem came to be a relatively short time ago in a decision known as Citizens United. What is Citizens United? Well, some folks in our country were starting to recognize that really rich corporations and people were pumping a lot of money into campaigns. They were putting commercials on television, putting them on the radio, putting them in the newspaper, and they passed a law to limit how much money could be spent on various campaigns and how. Well, the very, very rich and the very, very powerful didn't like that because they had formed what are known as political action committees. What's a political action committee? It's an imaginary entity with a fancy name. All right? It's usually a name that sounds really great. Freedom for Everybody, or Make America Great Again, or Citizens United for a Better America. They all sound awesome, don't they? And what happens with political action committees is rich folks pump money into it. And then that political action committee can spend money on elections for a particular candidate. But that wasn't enough. See, because with political action committees, folks could do a little homework and find out who contributed to the political action committee. And a lot of really rich, powerful people did not want people to know they were giving so much money.